Good evening, everybody. My name is Steve Abrams, and I'm going to be your master of ceremony this evening. And at this time, we want to do the most important thing. We're going to do the one thing that will change everything. We're going to thank God for this opportunity to be here. Amen? Amen. Let us pray. We're going to do the invocation. God, we just thank you for this opportunity to serve you. We thank you for each and every one of your servants that's in this building. God, you've given us health and strength today. Everything we do now is extra. We ask you to search our hearts and make sure everything that is in our heart is pure and for your glorification. In the name of the Father, in the name of the Son, and his precious name, Jesus Christ. Let us all say amen.
Amen.
Amen. I'm proud to stand here before you tonight as an adopted son of Brockton. I'm not original Brocktonian, but I'm an adopted son of Brockton, and I've learned the Brocktonian ways. One thing that I've learned, if you communicate in Brockton, something will get done. All right? If you continue the line of communication, lives will change, communities will change, people will change. And I stand here as an honor to be the MC tonight of the National Association of Advancement of Colored People, one of the anchors in this country of change. This organization has seen the best of times, the worst of times, but today is seeing the glorious of times, because we all are communicating, we all are standing in the presence of a great change in this community. So why not let Brockton be the beacon? Why not let Brockton be the first to say if they can do it there, they can do it anywhere, all right? All right. So what I'm going to do, my honor tonight, is to introduce some of the candidates. This is a conversation for a better tomorrow. And it's pretty much to talk and to come together and hear ideas. Because once we stop hearing ideas, things will not change. Everyone's opinion is very important. Everyone has a voice. So tonight, we want to keep that conversation going. We're going to acknowledge some people that are here tonight, and because of their presence, they acknowledge that the greatness of this organization, National Association of Advancement of Colored People, is an organization that deserves a place at the table at all times. It's an organization that has started from the bottom. Organization. The numbers have gone up, have gone down, but we still stand. We all know the great verse that Martin Luther King said, that injustice anywhere is injustice everywhere. He also said everything that he held on to, he lost. But everything that he put in the hands of God, he still possessed. So that's where we stand tonight, still possessing each other's comfort, each other's love, each other's humanity. So tonight, I'm going to introduce one of the matriarchs of the organization, one of the matriarchs of the movement. I found her to be a tireless soldier. I found her to be dedicated to details. She has done many committee work. She has worked tirelessly to bring up the Brockton National Association Advancement of Colored People's numbers and membership. And we're on the rise today. Nothing's going to stop us. Nothing's going to hold us back. So we're excited. This is an exciting time for the candidates. It's an exciting time for Brockton. It's an exciting time just to be a Brocktonian. Whenever you go throughout the state and you say you're from Brockton, everybody's like, whoa. And I tell them, whoa, you need to come see Brockton. Because the things that we are doing, we are an urban district high achieving. We are a high achieving urban district in all that we do and all that we say. So tonight we have some dignitaries here. We have some elected officials here. We have some candidates are running for office. We have Claire Cronin. Is she in the building? State Representative Claire Cronin. Let's give her a hand. Bob Sullivan, City Council, let's give him a hand. My godfather, Mr. Irineri, he's in the building. Can we give him a hand? Joanne Cody, is she in the building? All right. I'm going to mess up the last name. Nasarello? Nasarello. What's the name, Nasarello? Okay. Jimmy Pereira in the building? All right. We have some counselors that are running at large. We have, oh no, a gentleman, elected official, Mr. Wynn Farrell in the building. Mr. Bradley in the building? All right. Those who are running, we have Mr. Gary Keith. He's running. Counselor at large. Jacob Taggart, I've seen him in the building. Also for school committee. I seen Timothy Cruz. He's not for school committee, but city councilor. Thomas Monahan. Tom's at work. He's not here. Tina Cardoza. Get her hand, she's not here. Angel Gomes, he's in the building. Felicia, she's in the building. Susan DeCastro's in the building. I'm looking out, seeing who I see. Oh, Mr. Cassidy's in the building. Jerry Cassidy, state rep. Bishop Tony Branch is in the building. Raymond Henningsen, is he in the building? We also have in the building, no, in the back. Ann Beauregard's in the building. Ann, how can I forget your name? Also, the gentleman from Southeast Regional School Committee, Mark Lindy's in the building. All of our condolences, Mr. Lindy, all of our condolences, sir. Jimmy Pereira's came in the building. Anyone that I left out? Joyce Cizak's in the building. Shirley Azak's in the building. Help me out, like I told you. Clarice. Scott Hall's in the building. See, I'm just an adopted son of Brockton. I'm not original Brocktonian, so I know. Mr. Green's in the building. Let me see his name. Julio Pomaro. Julio Pomaro's in the building, running for mayor. Mike Carroll running for mayor. Anybody else? So we have all the, let's give all the candidates a round of applause. She's running for ward council. Yeah. I got her. We did that. That's okay. Thank you for your help. At this time, we also would like to acknowledge all the past presidents of the National Association of Advancement of Colored People. We want to thank all the past presidents who've done a great job in this organization. Can we give them a hand, Mr. Steve Bernard? Any other past presidents of the National Association of Advancement of Colored People? All right. At this time, it's my pleasure to introduce to some, present to others, Madam President, National Association of Advancement of Colored People. Phyllis, would you please come?
Good evening. Can you hear me? Most of you know me by all the emails I have sent out, and I will be sending more. On behalf of the Brockton Area Branch NAACP, we would like to welcome our members. Our members, can you hear me now? Testing. 1, 2, 3. On behalf of the Brockton Area Branch NAACP, we would like to welcome our members, the candidates, elected officials, and the members of the community. We thought it would be great to have all the candidates here just in a nice setting to talk to the community. They deserve it. They need a little break from their campaigning. You know, even though I said it's not going to be a political night, some of you want to speak. And I said, well, okay. So it has to be limited. But we're going to hear from a few candidates tonight. But for the Brockton NAACP, taking over as president, I am a proactive person. I like to get things done, as most of you know. When I talk about the NAACP, people tend to say, well, I didn't know we had a branch here. I'm like, what? We have been chartered since 1954. But I guess some members have fallen off, you know, for some reason or another. But I want these members to come back because we are energized and we are ready to go. Thank you. They also said that, well, if you are here, what are you guys doing? I'm like, what are we doing? We have been doing a lot. But you know, I'm like, they're saying we haven't done anything, so what can I do about that? So one Friday night, I emailed my friend Pat Monteith. I say, Pat, we need to do a newsletter. Now, this was Friday night. I woke up Saturday morning to my email. Pat had drafted the newsletter. I'm like, girl, you made my day, you know? So I brought it back to the committee. They approved it, and our first newsletter went out in July, letting people know what we have done, what we are going to do, all right? But we need members, okay? We cannot survive without members. Our branch has over 20 committees. Right now, we have 5 standing committees. The same people are on most of all of these committees. If we get more members in, we can get more people on the other committees, too, to go out and tackle all these problems that face us right now. We need to go back to the mission of the NAACP, and that's exactly what I'm going to do. I want to focus on crime. I want to focus on education, homelessness. I mean, you know, the homeless people here, it's a shame that they're on the street, you know? And we also, my pride and joy is the young people, the adults. But we have a dynamic AXO committee. We reestablished it 3 years ago with, again, talented Patricia Monteith. Each year we had students competing, and these kids are talented, biology, physics, engineering, you know, they come and they compete on the national, on the local level, they win the local gold medal, they go on to compete to the national level with 700 students there, and they bring home medals, you know. Each time we've gone there, the first year we competed in 2015, we had 2 students go, we brought home 2 silver medals. The next year we went, we had 3 students competing, we brought home the gold medal. And this year, we had 3 students going, and we brought home that gold again. So we are in the building, people, the students. And the good thing about the AXO program is that the students bring us their projects. We do not give them their projects. They can choose from 32 categories, and they choose what they want to do. So what we do, we bring them in, and we enhance their project by giving them mentors. You know, AXO is growing. Last year we had, well, this past year we had almost 24 students compete. You know, 12 of them won medals, and then 3 went on to the national. So I like the youth because they are our future, right? Okay? But I am stressing membership. I have membership forms here, okay? You guys got to sign up. Come to our next meeting, which is Monday, September 25th, to hear more about the branch and what we're going to be doing. We also have on display our AXO display in the back. We also have AgmiTech that we in partnership with, okay, for our health. We have an AXO committee, we have a health committee, we have the membership chair committee, religious chair committee. What am I missing? Education committee, but that's 5. We need more. So people, I'm not going to stand up here all night. I know you want to get up and talk and mingle with the people. We have great food, some of it cooked by own members. I didn't cook anything, but I provided some things, like the potato salad. So if you like it, I'll let you know who made it, you know? But eat, drink, and be merry, for tomorrow you'll be getting more emails from me. All right? Thank you.
At this time, we're going to have some quick, brief remarks. We have some remarkable things happening with AmniTech, with Men's Health, and you will hear that throughout the course of the night. But we're going to ask Mr. Sullivan. He has some prepared remarks, and we're going to ask all the people at least 2 minutes or less. Mr. Sullivan, would you please come? Let's give him a hand as he comes.
First of all, I want to say I can never stand up here next to someone dressed like that. Doesn't he look unbelievable? Huh? Look at that, huh? First of all, good evening. I want to thank everybody for being here tonight. I want to thank the NAACP for inviting me. My name is Bob Sullivan. Hopefully, I've met most of you in the past, but I'm serving as the City Council President. I've served 12 years as your Council at Large, meaning I serve the entire city of Brockton, all seven wards, all 28 precincts. The Council at Large election that's coming up, actually, we're not on this coming Tuesday's ballot. We get a push until November 7th. So when you go to the ballot, and I'm asking everybody that's a registered voter, we're nonpartisan in the city of Brockton, Democrat, Republican, unenrolled independents, please go to the polls this coming Tuesday for the preliminary election. You're not going to see anybody that's running for Council at Large, Winthrop, Jacobs, Scott Hall, myself, Mr. Keith. You're not going to see our names on that ballot, but in November, on Tuesday the 7th, you will. And at that time, you can vote for four people. I just want to, first of all, again, thank my good neighbor, Pat Monteith. Several years ago, I filed a resolve. I had never heard of AXO. And there was two individuals that lived in the city of Brockton that went to Southeastern Regional. And at that time, they weren't doing it for the Brockton NAAC chapter. They were doing Boston. And these two geniuses came before the city council. We gave them citations because they excelled. Subsequently, since that time, and kudos to everybody here, the chapter here in the City of Champions is really fostering champions. These boys and girls are excelling. They are our future. That's why this election coming up, it's great about the president of the City of Brockton. It's our community. It's our home. But it's for the future. It's for my 10-year-old, my 7-year-old, my 5-year-old. So I'm asking you respectfully to go to the polls Tuesday, vote in your ward. But then again, come November 7th, please go to the polls and vote. Robert Sullivan, Councilor at Large, I'm asking for one of your four votes, and I've said this before. I'm born in Brockton, I'm raised in Brockton, I married a Brockton gal, and people say, why do you stay in Brockton? Simple, it's home. It's my home, it's your home, and I'm asking you, we need to make sure our home is safe, and our voices are heard at City Hall, and I hope to continue to do that. God bless you all. Thank you.
At this time, we're going to have a candidate, one of the gentlemen that I've met, tireless worker in the city, a friend, Mr. Angel Gomes, if you please come forward.
Good evening, everybody. For the record, it's Angel Cosme, not Angel Gomes. That's somebody else, but that's all right. That's all right. You look too good to criticize you.
No, that's good. Help me out.
That's all right. So I have some prepared statements I am going to read because I want to get this right. I wanted to communicate why I'm running and for you to get to know a little bit of who I am. So good evening. I am a bit under the weather, but grateful to be here in the presence of our beloved community of Brockton. First of all, let me say thank you to the NAACP for hosting this candidate forum and for allowing the public the opportunity to engage with some of the candidates running for various elected positions. Encouraging community discourse with candidates for office is an excellent way to allow the public the opportunity to make an informed choice on election day, in some cases just 3 days away in some races. Some of you know me, and for those of you who don't, I'd provide a brief background. My name is Angel Manuel Cosme Jr. I'm Puerto Rican American, a father, a citizen, a resident, an educator, community activist, and I am running for Brockton Ward 2 City Councilor. I have a master's degree in education and a bachelor's degree in psychology, and I'm currently working as an educator with teaching licenses in moderate disabilities, secondary history, as well as sheltered English instruction. Throughout the years, I have worked as a community organizer professionally and as a volunteer. I was involved in the creation of a Brockton drug court in opposing the proposed casino, advocating for immigration and criminal justice reform, education equity, economic dignity, youth empowerment, and I've worked within specialized educational institutions centered on recovery from alcohol and drugs, technical curriculums, and special education, and I have participated in many state and national elections and served as a campaign manager for a local mayoral race here in Brockton a couple of years ago. I gravitate towards service with altruism involving issues of equality and social justice, of community and love for humanity, because I wholeheartedly believe in the well-being of all. I will fight for fair access to resources of upward mobility and won't shy enough to remark that I am all the more resolved when there has been a historical, systemic assault on marginalized populations who, because of bigotry, systemic inequalities, and division, have suffered their fair share of access to upward mobility pursuits. Indeed, it is appropriate for us to think of prosperity at all levels, but it is my spiritual and my personal belief that we should never do so at the expense of our elderly, our poor, the homeless, immigrants, our veterans, the communities of color, women, and those addicted to substances. We must eradicate divisiveness centered around race, gender, social class, and other divisions that only serve to separate us. When we look out for our self-interests and for those within our in-group, however that's defined, a disproportionate discrepancy surfaces that disproportionately favors a certain group or segment over the population. The result of such practices could be witnessed here in Brockton with the existing anti-immigrant sentiment that's here, the foreclosure crisis, increased rents, inequitable and unjust educational funding, resulting in lost occupations, compounded by a scarcity of good-paying jobs. The lack of resources and compassion for the homeless and those suffering from substance abuse, and a tendency to devalue the contributions of our elderly and the veterans are clear testimonies that we can and we must do better. When we work together, we can achieve a Brockton of which the likes we haven't seen, with no disrespect to the glory days of the past, at least for some who benefited from its success. In closing, I intend to be the candidate and leader, the elected official who brings people, institutions, and organizations together out of our collective interests and our common humanity. As Ward 2 City Councilor, I would be that voice on the council that would base decisions on the greater good of most, on consultation and public discourse, and out of an appreciation for morality, equality, and equal access to goods and resources for all residents in Brockton. On November 7th, you have a choice to elect the first Puerto Rican and educator on the city council. More importantly, you will have a city councilor who would advocate for all residents equally with persistent determination and resolve. During the last 4 years, the Ward 2 city councilor position was unopposed, and in a democracy like ours, it is encouraged for the citizens to step up. I think that's my calling, so I'm just gonna, if you can give me 10 more seconds, I promise I'm gonna wrap it up. I wanted to get this right. If you want a voice on the council that has years of organizing, educating, volunteering, and advocating for a better Brockton, then consider me. My name is Angel Manuel Cosme. I'm honored to have your consideration as Ward 2 City Councilor, and please consider me on November 4th. Thank you. God bless you. Good night.
You can tell he's a fast learner. The next distinguished person who has signed up, and we will get to everyone they have to speak, City Councilor Ward 2, Mr. Dennis Arineri, if you could please come. I'm messing up. Three, Ward 3. No, it says 2 right here, but it's 3.
Thank you. Thank you. It's a great honor and a privilege to be here. And, you know, just when I was standing to the back and hearing the new president speak, just to date myself, I guess I do that occasionally. But I can remember when I began so many years ago, when you came to the NAACP, you actually came and you were introduced by a lovely lady called Nan Ellison. And Nan goes back many years. She was one of the founders when I started to serve of the city of Brockton as a member of the Brockton School Committee. So it's nice to see a group of people here today, tonight. It's nice to see an arrangement of a group of people, I should say, more or less, because our city is just what you're seeing here now is a multicultural urban city, and it's great. It really is. But let me just reintroduce myself to you. Dennis Arineri, city councilor from Ward 3. I've held the position for the last 14 years. And I am a candidate for re-election, and I am on this Tuesday's ballot. Prior to that, I did also serve the great parents and children of Ward 5 as a member of the Brockton School Committee for 20 years previous to being the counselor from Ward 3. Tuesday is a very important date and day because it is a primary election, and sometimes primary elections can do some funny tricks. And this election has been a little different for me, to be truthful with you. For whatever reason, there's some other people that have already entertained who they'd like to see, you know, in my seat and move me along. But I got news for them. I've been out there working very feverishly. I might have a little problem with my knee and my hip, but it hasn't stopped me. I'm still meeting and greeting with people. I was out there just today, and had a long conversation with the former superintendent of schools, Matt George, who is a longtime resident of Ward 3, meeting with him for about an hour this afternoon. So for anybody to say that I'm not out there, I don't do my job, no one knows who he is, stop it. It's not true, because I've been around for a good many years, and I've enjoyed all the years I've served this city, and I mean that immensely, because it's a great city, and even as it is today, it's still a great city. But what we need to do is to keep people like myself and others in place so that we can continue to move the city forward and work for everyone. Right now, there's a concerted effort out there. We only work for certain individual groups, and that is not correct. So I ask for your help and support, those that are here from Ward 3 and those that you do know that live in Ward 3, to please come out on Tuesday to renominate me so I can get to the election. And I promise you I'll take the election and I will win it. And I'll continue to represent the people of Ward 3, all of the people of Ward 3. That's my job. That's what I've done. There's a lot of things left to do. We have quite a few things to do. But I still want to continue to serve the great city of Brockton because I am a true Brocktonian, and I know you are too as well. So thank you. I appreciate the opportunity to speak tonight. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you very much. Our next speaker, when you hear the music, that means dance to the left, dance to the right. We're going to help you out. City Councilor, Ward 4, Susan DeCastro. Am I getting it right? All right.
Good evening, everyone. Thank you. I'm honored to be here this evening, and I want to thank Phyllis Ellis, Stephen Bernard, and NAACP for inviting me. I've lived in Ward 4 in Brockton for 27 years since I married my husband, and I have a lot of experience in the city of Brockton, having spent 5 years on the planning board. You can't hear me? How's that? Is that better? Okay, thank you. I've lived in Brockton for 27 years, always in Ward 4. My husband is a lifer in Ward 4. And in these years, I've gained a lot of experience in Brockton and in Ward 4. I served 5 years on the planning board of the city of Brockton and 2 years on the Zoning Board of Appeals. I've been an attorney for more than 30 years, specializing in real estate and business. And I must tell you, I'm very proud to be an attorney. In all these years, 30 plus years, I've helped many people buy many houses and sell houses and also buy and sell many businesses. I volunteer throughout the city for the Brockton Garden Club. I'm the chair of their scholarship committee. The Brockton Library Foundation, the Democratic City Committee, where I serve as both the chair of the Ward 4 committee, and we're growing, and the secretary of the entire city committee. I most recently got involved with the Keith Park Neighborhood Association. My first love for volunteering in Brockton is the Charity Guild of Brockton. I've been on their board for nearly 20 years, where we run a food pantry and a thrift store. We mostly serve, well, more than 50% of our customers are children and seniors. We feed a lot of people throughout the year, and we provide household goods and clothing to a lot of people. Feeding people good food is a passion of mine. Ward 4 and Brockton need experienced leadership on the City Council. I believe experience, integrity, and character are key and are what count most in this race. I'm not beholden to anyone, never was and never will be. And so those of you who are from Ward 4 and the friends of you who aren't from Ward 4, I ask for your vote. Thank you.
Thank you very much. We're going to ask all the candidates when they do come, because we are recording, to speak into this mic right here so we can pick you up. The next candidate's going to come up to speak is Mr. Jimmy Pereira. Is he in the building?
Hello, hello. Good evening, everyone. All right, see, I love the energy. Again, name is Jimmy Pereira, mayoral candidate for the city of Brockton. And come Tuesday, I am looking to have your support. A few reasons why you should vote for me. Again, being a born and raised resident here in the city of Brockton, Massachusetts, I was an at-risk youth. I am very familiar with the struggles that we go through, especially for our youth in the city of Brockton. But I was able to persevere. I ended up in the foster care system and landed in Springfield, Massachusetts. There I went to vocational school. I learned sheet metal and welding. I learned the importance of having a skilled trade and how to utilize that. And now that I own a home, I know it's very, very useful. So with that said, I wanted to further my education, so I went to Westford State University. I majored in geography and regional planning. I minored in ethnic and gender studies so I could collaborate with society and how we live in the built environment. Concluding that, I graduated 2013, I went to work for the city of Springfield, a city of a population of 153,000. I worked closely with the mayor, the city council there, the engineering and the planning department, and I instructed them and educated them on how to improve bicycle pedestrian accommodations for the residents. Following that, they offered jobs, but I wanted to come back home to my city. Brockton is my pride and joy. It's diverse in culture, and its open arms is what made me come back, and the food, of course, as well. But coming back, I wanted to work for the city. I didn't get the opportunity. I persevered, and I ended up working for the regional planning agency. That made me know more about what's going on in the community. When you ask about experience, I have that experience. I worked with communities, not just Brockton, but neighboring communities as well, and see the faults and issues that we have not addressed and the opportunities that have passed us by. Also, engaging the Department of Youth Services and working with at-risk youth, I continue to do that. I am a motivational speaker for them. I'm also an example for them that shows that no matter what your background is, no matter what troubles and tribulations that you go through, you can still succeed. It is not the end until your last breath, and that's what I show to them, and I want to continue to show that to our youth here in the city. What I learned is looking at the problem-oriented approach. Look at the problems, provide solutions. If those solutions don't work, you go back to the drawing board and you bring it back. This Tuesday, please vote for someone that's going to work hard for the city. I've went through loops and bounds to come back to the city, to work hard for the city. Even when opportunities weren't granted, I fought through and I made sure that I'd be able to work for the city hand in hand. So please, come Tuesday, vote for somebody that has integrity, that's honest, that's going to be innovative, and that's going to be inclusive as well. Thank you, and I hope to have your support. Thank you. Thank you.
Love y'all.
Love you all, okay?
Take care.
Thank you. We have another distinguished gentleman in the back running for mayor. And we're going to ask him if he would please come and give a 2-minute remark. Mr. Palmera, if he would please come.
Everybody hear me okay? Yes. All right, thank you. I want to thank the NAACP local chapter for hosting this event, and that's something I hope that we can do again and again.
Can't hear you.
Yeah, really? How about now? Okay, I'm talking to the wrong one, too many microphones. Again, I'd like to thank the NAACP local chapter for hosting this event, something hopefully we can do again and again. Still can't hear me? My wife never can hear me anyway. My name is Julio Pomar. I was born in South America. I came to the United States when I was 5 years old. I came right here to Brockton. I moved several areas in Brockton, and I currently live in the Village. It is my privilege to run for mayor here in the city of Brockton, a city I love very much, places I've worked all over the state, and I've always considered Brockton my home, and I always will. My wife is also a Brocktonian, sixth generation. She loves the city as much as I do. There's nobody in this city you're going to find that's going to work as hard as he possibly can to get the things that the people here need. We need integrity in our city hall. We need people who are backing our public servants. We want us public servants to work harder and work better. Some of them do work hard, but they need a little bit of support to make them have pride in their jobs and pride in what they do. And in so doing that, they will also, the people who live in the city, the Brocktonians and the citizens of Brockton, will see how well they do their jobs, how well they hope to inspire them to do the same thing. It's going to take more than just one man doing everything he can to get the city back in line. Everybody has to buy into the thought that Brockton can be a better place than what it is right now. And I know it can be, and I want to be the person to lead everybody to that. I know I can be. Starting on Tuesday is the primary election, and I hope I have your vote so I can continue to do that and work for you and do the best as I can, and hopefully you guys will follow me and give me a vote at that time. Thank you.
Thank you very much. Next coming to the podium, Mrs. Ann Beauregard. One that's never lost for words. Let me fix it, I'll fix it.
Yeah, you fix it.
How's that? There you go.
Thank you, dear. Well, don't let nothing stand in your way. I'm Ann Beauregard, and I'm your Ward 5 City Councilor, and I intend to stay that way. I'm the one that's working to make sure that we don't have any more private ways and all the streets are public in this city so they eventually can get paved. That costs money. Well, I'm working for economic development. And if you don't believe me, ask the people that I'm driving crazy. If it's not the planning board, it's the zoning board. It's Tech Review, it's the Metro South Chamber of Commerce. And I don't let up, okay? Not that that surprises anyone. I got involved in Brockton in 1996 when Shannon O'Brien was running for treasurer, the first female treasurer of the Commonwealth of Massachusetts, for the second time, and I said, I'll do anything to see you get elected. I said, I live in Brockton. She said, all right, people get you in touch. You'll find out what to do. Well, let me tell you, my life has not been the same since. I've hung around with some very hardworking individuals, stuffed envelopes, and did drops. It's all glamour and glory in this business. At all hours of the day and night, all locations throughout the southern part of Massachusetts, actually, if you do a county race or whatever. I've had the honor and privilege of seeing many people elected that, are so dignified and an honor. And we're very fortunate to have them, whether it's John Buckley or was Shannon O'Brien as the first female treasurer, or it was individuals over the years that have worked for the city in various capacities. I mean, you're Ward 5 city councilor, but you serve the entire city because you don't ignore a problem in another area. You work with others to do that. I can always be reached at 774-297-4939. Yes, that's my cell phone number, and you can call me, and I will get back to you. I weigh things out. If there's a real serious crime problem, I'll get to you sooner than if there's a parking issue or a trash issue. But I assure you that I will get to you. And all the department heads will tell you that. They love me. They're just very fond of me because if I don't speak to them on a regular basis every week, I email all of them every week because there's a whole lot to do. This is a city of over 100,000 people. There are so many great people in the city, and I'm going to name one that is beyond remarkable, and that's Kathleen Smith, the first female superintendent of the fourth largest public school system in the Commonwealth. And I intend to work with her, as I have for almost 20 years now, in a variety of different capacities. I serve on the Adult Learning Center Advisory Board. English is not my first language like some of the others in this room. So yes, I'm going to keep ESL going. And Miles, you can do that tomorrow morning after church, okay? So anyway, no, in all seriousness, my election is not till November 7th. Get out there this Tuesday on September 19th. I'm here to serve you, and join me at my Ward 5 meeting on September 26th at the Plouffe Academy, where a whole lot of remarkable students go on and do remarkable things like be parts of ACSALP. Thank you.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Once again, we're going to start our program app. We're going to ask everybody if they please take their seats. This is the program that we're going to go through real quick because everybody wants to start dancing and enjoying each other's company. Is that okay?
Yeah.
So if everybody could please take their seats at this time. I think I saw Senator Brady come in the building. Did he leave? Senator Brady's in the building. Senator Brady, thank you so much. Once again, the National Association for Advancement of Colored People want to welcome you and thank you. We're going to continue our program. And our next speaker, school committee, Ward 6, Felisa Chalmers.
Hello, everyone. My name is Felisa Chalmers, and I'm running for Ward 6 School Committee. I am a mother of five. I have three children in the Brockton School. You can't hear me? I'm sorry. Can you hear me now? Is that better?
Go ahead.
I'm sorry. So, Felisa Chalmers, I'm running for Ward 6 School Committee member. I have, I'm a homeowner in Ward 6, and I'm also a Brockton resident. I have three children in the Brockton public school system and a granddaughter. I am a member of Messiah Baptist Church, where I founded the Parent Advocacy Ministry. And what we do is we help parents to find services and get connected with different organizations within the city. We also make food Thanksgiving baskets, and we do Christmas baskets also. And we ask other families to adopt families in need. My goals are to adopt a fiscally sound budget along with other members of the school committee to regularly monitor the funds throughout the year, to review and approve the school budget through extensive discussion and prioritization of each item with more community input. I feel that it is important for parents in the community to come out and to hear what is going on at the school committee meetings, because these are our children and we need to know what is happening. Also, I like to be able to set long-range goals along with the other members, which will allow for multi-year budgeting, eliminating fiscal surprises, and build trust within the system to communicate the needs of our schools to other levels of local and state government, and advocate for a strong educational system and its funding. And I'm asking you to remember the name, Felisa Chalmers, Ward 6 School Committee. Thank you.
I told you, Brockton has its best and brightest. Brockton has its best and brightest in this city. Our next candidate, Doris Smith. She can come to the mic.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. My name is Doris Smith, and I'm a candidate for Ward 5 City Council. I'd like to say especially thank you to the NAACP and the new leadership. And also, I want to acknowledge the public service of myself and the incumbent, who I'm looking to unseat. I do want to say that both of us have had years of public service, and we are going to let the voters of Ward 5 make the decision on who is the candidate that they will elect to that seat. My platform is safety, diversity, pro-business, and education. And I'd like to say, lastly, that I have made a pledge, as you will see in my brochure, that I, in my past, have received 100% financial aid assistance to undergraduate all-women's college for my undergraduate degree. And I'm pledging to help any high schooler who wants to further their education and help work so that they can secure 100% financial assistance to secure their future. Thank you so much and have a good day.
Thank you. Our next candidate, I gotta raise this up for him, big guy. City Council at large. One thing about all the candidates that they have done, and I've known them personally, their compassion for veterans and helping veterans in their family issues. One of my veteran alumni is put his name in the hat to continue that effort. And we're gonna ask right now at this time, Mr. Gary Keith, if he can please come forward.
Good evening. I want to thank the NAACP for hosting this forum. Thank you, Phyllis. And I want to thank you to all the candidates that are running right now for all the different positions right now. Doris, how are you? Excuse me. My name is Gary Keith, Sr., and I'm running for City Council at large. I have served since the age of 17 years old when I enlisted in the U.S. Army as a veteran. I have a background in law enforcement. I have the experience of sitting on, I had the pleasure and gained the experience of sitting on the Planning Board and Zoning Board of Brockton for the past 4 years and currently serving there still. I'm a former chairperson for the state of Massachusetts for Head Start and for self-help Head Start here locally. My wife and I, my wife Kathy right here, that we've been married now for 31 years, have raised our 7 kids here in the city of Brockton, and all have gone through the Brockton public school systems, with one left right now who's a senior who will be graduating in this next year. My son, if some of you all might have seen, that was here earlier, just started his 3rd year at American International College on a full scholarship playing Division II football. So I have some life experiences and I bring some professional experiences to this position of running for city councilor at large. I have, like I said, I've worked with the last 4 years of with our mayor and with the current city council, okay, of applications that have come in front of me on the zoning board and the planning board, and I've helped out a lot of people in the city. I've also, I was instrumental in opening the doors of Lincoln Congregational Church on Oak Street, which sat empty for 8 years. Okay, I was also instrumental in shutting down Montello Gas Station down there for selling synthetic marijuana. So as a community activist, I've been active in this city doing things that some of you don't need to know about, and I don't need to basically pat myself on the back for those accolades. Okay, serving is something that I've done all my life. I'm a 27-year member of Jubilee Church, where I also have served in ministry for numerous years as an armor bearer to the bishop. So with that, basically I have a lot of great feedback that I'm getting from the citizens of Brockton and from our business owners here who are supporting my candidacy to succeed. Shayna Bonds, who has served as well, but now there is an open seat. There are 8 members, there are 8 candidates running for council at large, and I'm asking you today that you can cast one of your 4 votes for me, and I can guarantee you these things. I will continue to be transparent, I will continue to be consistent, which I have been for the past 4 years of serving here in the city government, and I will always use my experience and consult with the highest power in the land, my great Lord upstairs, before I make any decisions that will affect the city of Brockton. But one thing that I can always, you can always guarantee that you're going to get from me is 100% honesty. And I'm accessible. My number is available. You can see my wife. You can see my friends. I will get back to you, or you just come and knock on my door. My name is Gary Keith Sr., and I'm asking you for your vote on November 7th as your next city councilor at large. Thank you.
Thank you very much. At this time, we're going to ask Raymond Henningsen, Ward 7, if he would please come forth.
Down, yeah. Going to take care of our short people here. Good evening, everybody. I'm going to say a few things. I'm not going to hold up this whole thing too much. I'm going to do a little Tony Branch here. I don't know if I can pull it off completely, but first I want to thank the NAACP for holding the event. I'm a proud member of the NAACP and serve on the executive committee. I also want to thank Fred Fontaine, who owns this great venue. It truly is the perfect place. I also want to thank my son and wife who are here tonight and have put up with a lot of my campaigning, and that's not easy for any of us candidates. So give a round of applause for all of the candidates tonight. You know, it's not easy running. It takes a lot of time, a lot of effort, a lot of, you know, time away from our family and friends. But, you know, I'm a candidate for Ward 7 School Committee, and I want you to know why I'm running. You know, there's a saying I have now, and I'm going to say it, and I'm going to actually have you guys say it. Our children, our future, one Brockton. Say that with me. So for that, you know, that means we need to give our children the opportunity of a great public education. Our children, you know, they may be 20% of our population, but they're 100% of our future. So I'm the candidate with 2.5 decades of financial experience. I'm a vice president of finance with a multi-million dollar corporation. You know, I bring a lot to the table with budgets, and I understand what our teachers go through every day. I'm an advocate for our special needs population. I'm an advocate for our diversity. When I talk about diversity, I don't just talk about diversity. I actually mean it. I actually set up through my own small, but, you know, it's whatever I could financially do, a small scholarship for any young man or woman who wants to enter this teaching profession. Because I believe that if we want to increase the diversity in our schools, we have to start with our children first. We want them to get into the field of teaching. We want them to know what it is to have the great love of being a teacher. And these are, you know, besides our parents, these are, you know, the best influences on our children's lives. So I wanted you to know that I have, you know, all that experience, knowledge, and love for our kids. If you don't know about me, you probably have heard about me with school supply drives, various drives without the city. I do these because I believe that every kid deserves the great public education that we give them. Our next school committee will most likely be electing the next superintendent. So think about that when you're electing your officials, because we will be electing the next superintendent most likely. And we need to make sure that we have a superintendent in place who's going to ensure that we have diversity in our schools, diversity in the administration. We need more diverse people in the administration and in our teaching ranks. And that's one of the promises that I make, is I will work hard with our next superintendent to ensure that we do that. And not just talk the talk. We're going to get out there. We're going to put ads in papers. We're going to do what we need to. But I want to thank you tonight and have a good night. And thanks for having me.
Thank you so much, Ray. One thing I've learned being a member of the National Association of Advancement of Colored People, we extend personal integrity to all citizens, all people. There's only one color. So National Association of Advancement of Colored People, under our new Madam President, we extend these courtesies to all that's in this country, that's all in this city. So we ask you to continue to do that. You guys have been great tonight. And we're going to ask our next candidate, Joyce Azak, if she would please come forward.
Thank you. I would like to definitely thank the NAACP for inviting me. Where do I start? I am serving my first term as school committee member for Ward 6. I have lived in Ward 6 for 34 years and pretty much attended Franklin School, Brookfield School, North Junior High, which is technically Ward 7, but in Ashfield for a short time. So as far as serving as your school committee member and being so involved within my community for Ward 6, I'm familiar with Ward 6. As far as serving, we are on so many subcommittees, whether it's finance, accounts review. There's so many subcommittees that I can list and go on and on. But I know so many candidates would like to come up and say a few words. As far as your school committee member, I'm pretty much hands-on. Every constituent that's contacted me, I have taken care of the situation, and if I haven't, we're still working on it. We've done things from signage for Ashfield School, Brookfield School's parking lot, speed bumps, the conditions of our schools. We've focused as a team and worked so hard to get things done. So if those that are not familiar with our schools, as far as Brookfield and Ashfield, I'd love to take you on a tour and show you what we've done. I don't specifically just focus on my two schools. I'm serving the community. So I've had calls for surrounding schools, and we've addressed a lot of issues that have always come up. Yes, we are in a difficult budget. We are working so hard on that budget, and fingers crossed, hopefully we do not see a horrible budget like we did this year, as far as 2018. You know, I wanna commend my colleagues on the committee. We met, we did not take a summer break. We were meeting weekly, sometimes 2-3 times a week, whether it was finance and other subcommittees to try to work through this budget. As far as the students, I attend pretty much the PTO meetings. I'm hands-on. I love attending the fun events. We have the fun events at our schools. Those are what keep me grounded and appreciate for what I do. Seeing the students' faces, seeing what we're doing for them. So, you know, we have some fun times. And most recently, for those that didn't know, I tried to reach out to a lot of parishes, a lot of organizations, but I was able to work with Cradles to Crayons, and we got 2,000 backpacks. So, you know, we did our best to reach out to different communities. And I know I've reached out to the Cape Verdean community, the Haitian community, a few other parishes to try to help them out with the backpacks. So we do have a lot that we always do behind the scenes. I'm not one that's always out there, I did this, I did that. That's not me. We did this. So without a team, I can't do anything alone. So I work very well with our facilities department, Mr. Thomas, and we pretty much get a lot done. So communication is very important when you're holding this seat. And I just want everyone to know, school committee meets more than just once a month. We pretty much meet 2-4 times a week sometimes. So it's a dedication. You have to be dedicated and have that time to give. So, November 7th, vote Joyce Azak as your Ward 6 school committee member. I need another term to finish what I've started. Thank you.
Once again, the National Association of Advancement of Colored People want to thank all the candidates that put their hat in the race. Our next candidate is running for mayor, Mr. Michael Carroll. Could you put your hands together as he comes forward?
Yeah, I think so. Speaking to the silver.
Hi, my name is Mike Carroll. I've been a resident of Brockton for the past 14 years, a homeowner of 9. I think one of the biggest issues in Brockton is generating revenue and luring companies in. Be my main focus to provide to the areas which need more funding, which is public safety and education. By doing so, I would use tax incentives to lure companies in that would be individualized, customizable, with incentives to hire residents of Brockton. I think a big part of for the ability of Brockton's economy to boom would be for outside towns and cities to come in and spend their money for our local economy to survive. By cleaning up main roadways entering Brockton, whether it's with basic landscaping, green space, or enforcing local ordinances, I think is very important. I don't think we can continue just to chase the state for money and raise taxes. We need to think outside the box with new innovating ways to generate revenue. Anyone has any more, would like to know anything more about me, I do have a website, electmikecarroll.com, with a detailed plan, or if you'd like to contact me, you can contact me through there or Facebook. Thank you.
Thank you. At this time, Ward Ford, running for Ward Ford Counselor, Bishop Tony Branch.
If it's okay with you all, I'm going to speak in the tradition of the church that has been the political power of the black community since they allowed us to start reading the Bible during slavery. Is that all right? Yeah. You just made my 10 seconds come back. Stole my minutes. For the Bible says, if my people who are called by my name will humble themselves and pray and seek my face and turn from their wicked ways, then I will hear from heaven and I will forgive their sin and I will heal their land. Look at your neighbor and tell your neighbor, say, neighbor, it's time to heal the land, and the land is Brockton. Now, I don't know who y'all been talking to. I don't need to tell you my name. You know me by my experience. I've been going here and fro in this community. And although that I had notes tonight, I want to let you know what I need to really say from the heart. If, in fact, those folks that have the experience have been representing us, we wouldn't be in the condition that we're in. Come on and talk back to me in here tonight. If they have paid attention to us, you wouldn't need a preacher to be up here today to talk to you and to tell you that I'm running for city council. Am I making sense to you? If they had listened to us on diversity, you wouldn't have needed Bishop Branch. If they had listened to us in terms of affordable housing, you wouldn't need Bishop Branch. If they had listened to us today, you wouldn't be paying all that money that you're going to pay on that discrimination lawsuit. So I don't know where anybody else has been, but I've been with you. So my question to you is on Tuesday, are you going to vote for change or are you going to stick with the same thing? If you're going to vote for change, just yell change. Why y'all afraid to talk back in here? If you're going to vote for change, yell change. All right now. So who am I talking to today? I made notes because I've spoken to so many people over the last days. So for you in the camera, I'm talking to the Morales family that's on Main Street and looking for affordable housing. We in the NAACP, we hear you. I'm talking to the Johnson family who wants to start a small business and would like to take one of those buildings and convert it to condominium offices and studios for artists. We in the NAACP, we hear your cry. I'm talking to the Texera family who's just looking for a neighborhood school and sending your child across the city. You want to cut down on transportation costs. We hear your cries. And finally, I'm speaking to the Al's family, who has a disabled mother who's unable to ambulate based upon the use of their wheelchair. We're speaking to you in terms of traffic enforcement. So I don't know who anybody else has been talking to, but I know one thing, that on Tuesday at 7 o'clock in the morning, we need to stand united, not for black people, not for white people, but what is for right. If you believe that, say we believe in Brockton. Yeah.
If anybody wasn't listening, we're listening now. Is that all right? I wish I could have my friend say some words, but he said he don't want to say nothing. I wish I had my friend say some words, Mr. Taggart, but he said he don't want to say nothing. Can I? Hey, we family. I'm sorry, we family.
Listen, I know the majority of you guys here. I'm not going to come up here and play politics. I came for chicken and potato salad. That's it. All right? I'm running for council at large. I'm looking for 1 of 4 votes. That's it. I hope you guys all enjoy your night. Well, let's get the party started. Let's go.
See, I told you. Like I said, we all family. Ain't no stopping us now. Last but not least, gentleman that we all know running for city council at large, Mr. Gene Bradley, would you come forth?
Well, Steve, thank you so much. And before I start, I would like to thank the NWCB for putting this together, and of course, our new president. Could you guys put your hands together for our new president? I mean, I think so far, I think you folks can see that she's doing a wonderful job, and thank you so much, and I look forward to more. And of course, I would like to thank each and every single one of you, especially the candidates who take the time to put your name on the ballot. It's not an easy game, it is not. And to see you guys take the responsibility to get engaged, to put your name out there, and put your family's name out there, it's something that I personally have the most respect for. And as you know, politics can be nasty sometimes, but at the end of the day, we are all people. Regardless what it is after the elections, I would like us to live together as brothers and sisters, not as those people and that people and that people. So I think it's just foolish. So for me, thank you so much for doing this, and thank you so much for having the inspirations to move Brockton forward. It means a lot to me. So before I start, let me just say this. For those of you who don't know me, my name is Gene Bradley de Guenancourt. I was born in Haiti, and I came in this country in 2010. Yes, 2010. I came in this country after the earthquake, if you recall. And when I first came in this country, 6 years and a half ago, I could not speak a word of English. Fortunately, with the help of a wonderful sister, I was able to start learning English at the Brockton Public Library, where I'm serving now as one of the trustees. And from there, I moved to Massasoit, graduated with 2 majors, liberal arts and criminal justice. I'm not a cop, but I do have a background on law enforcement to understand the complexity of that. And unfortunately, the student at Massasoit, I think it was like 9,000, voted for me to be the first Haitian American as a student trustee. I serve on the board of trustee. And then from there, I'm serving at the board of trustee for the YMCA. Why do I'm saying this? I'm saying this because we are the city of champion. In this city, we have all kinds of people. We have tall people, we have short people. It's okay, that's part of life. But what I've seen in Brockton is the ability for us to work together with the diversity that we have. So for me, going to Massasoit was kind of like very challenging. He's this kid from Haiti, not knowing how to speak English, but trying to survive. From there, we survived, and then I went to Suffolk University. That's where I got my bachelor in political science and international diplomacy. As of right now, I'm doing a master over there. So I'm saying this because a few of you talked about education, especially Ray, for our children, and I think it's important. So for me, in terms of like work, my first job in the city was at Christo's. I worked at Christo's as a busboy for 2 years while I was going to Massasoit. From Christo's, I started working for Raise Up Massachusetts in collaboration with the Coalition for Social Justice. We passed question 4 on the ballot where everybody was able to get earned sick time, if you recall, in 2014. I started working for the former mayor of the city, Linda Balzodi, and of course, the former governor of Massachusetts. As we speak, I work for Senator Brady. That's my job. Why do I say this? Because I think it's matter. I think it's important. So tonight, I stand before you, not as somebody who knows it all or can do it all. I stand before you as a Brocktonian, as a citizen, as somebody who become an American. I changed my nationality because I believe in this city. So I hope on November 7th, I can count on one of your 4 votes. Regardless what it is, I would like us to come together the next day to live as Brocktonian. Thank you. God bless you. And God bless our great city. I love you all. Thank you.
We want to thank Gene for that.
I'm going to have to apologize. We have one gentleman, Mr. Scott Hall. I'm going to ask him to come forward. And after Mr. Scott Hall, Madam President of the National Association of Colored People will be giving us closing remarks, and then we will begin to start tearing up this dance floor. Is that okay?
So I'm Scott Hall. I'm a lifelong Brocktonian. I've got about 18 years professional computer programming experience, primarily with Microsoft Technologies. I'm not a fan of partisan politics. It's very divisive. We need to unite Brockton and sit down like adults and solve all the problems. With that being said, someone was talking about foreclosure crisis and homelessness. Homelessness, like most people think opioid addiction, you know, a drug addiction is the main, well, it is the main cause of homelessness, but there's also rampant foreclosure fraud, mortgage fraud, notary fraud, securities fraud going on. And right now in the state of Massachusetts, we have non-judicial foreclosure, and we need to make it judicial foreclosure so people can go into court and say, this is how I've been wronged. A lot of these banks are ripping off everybody and getting away with it because there's no judicial foreclosure. They're just pushing it right through the court system. State Senator Tom Kennedy sponsored a bill to change it from non-judicial foreclosure to judicial foreclosure. And it got killed in committee. I'm hoping to work with our representatives at the State House to get this passed along so we can see an end to this. You know, these banks, these big banks. Credit unions are great, but these big banks are just ripping off everybody, and we gotta unite and say enough's enough, because that's killing Brockton. Also, economic development in the downtown area. We need it. We gotta get serious about it. Why aren't we on the list for Amazon to come into Brockton? You know, let's get people together that say we want Amazon in Brockton. You know, it's a lot more affordable. The location is probably way better than a congested Boston, or I think it's Framingham or Fitchburg is the other city talking about it, but we should be on the list. We should be at the top of the list. There's plenty of affordable warehouse space in the city that we can utilize. And with that being said, take care, God bless. Have a good night.
It's me again. I'm going to close out now, but the party is not over. But before I do, we have applications from members. Anyone who wants an application, please see me. Our next meeting is Monday, September 25th, and we're going to get the party started. Thank you all for coming. It was our pleasure to have all the candidates here. I think they've done a great job talking. Let's give them a round of applause. And we're going to have a closeout prayer by Steve Abrams here.
Could everybody that's close, could you join hands together? Could everybody please join hands together? We came in as a family. We're going to leave as a family. These hands that you're holding, these hands are able to do great things. These hands will change Brockton. These hands will begin to move forward the conversation. Let us pray. Father God, we thank you in the mighty name of Jesus. We call on that name because that's the only name that we know that has the authority, that has the dominion, that every knee shall bow, every tongue confess. Watch over us tonight, and a special blessing to Madam President, God, as she does this endeavor like never before. The National Association for Advancement of Colored People, we desire to do your will and our will. In Jesus' name, we all say amen.
Amen. Amen.